Welcome to another video. In this video, we are going to talk about ignition systems, and specifically, we're going to look at some secondary ignition waveforms. We'll use the standard secondary lead from PicoScope. We'll use their little COP wand a little bit to see how that differs. We're going to talk about the waveform and do an experiment. So we're going to take and regap one of these spark plugs, see what it does to the waveform, and see what we can learn from it. We know that the gap of the plug is going to change it. We know things like compression are going to change it. So we're just going to take a small bite at gap and see what that does. So we're going to start with this setup here. So I've got my secondary lead, just standard secondary lead from the PicoScope set. I've got one of their high tension leads and my coil pack is out, right? So this lead is giving me a place to gather information right here. So we're going to go to the software and set up for our waveform. So I'm going to go to channel A. I'm going to select my probe. We've got the PicoScope 4425 box today. So we're going to have to tell it what probe we've got. We're going to go for the secondary ignition probe that's inverted. And you can see that's got a fire line on the positive side. I get these two choices, and sometimes I've got to work between them. So you see, if I pick positive here, it is firing down below. We want to see it go up. So we're going to stick with inverted. Come back here. We're going to step up our voltage range. Make sure we've got everything on the screen. We're going to go down to trigger, put an automatic trigger. Pull that up on the fire line and look at a little less time so I can see this whole event just right there in the middle of the screen. So I'm going to set that there, pull this down a little bit. We've got a pretty nice picture there. All right, so next let's add that COP wand. So we're going to go to the B channel. It is just an X1 probe. It's just going to read out in kind of a low voltage. We're going to go ahead and select a 1-volt scale. And we'll go and move that COP wand and get it set up right on top of my ignition coil. And you can see we pretty much get, we'll move this one up so we can see it by itself. We really get the same image, right? But it is upside down, it's inverted. So let's fix that. We're going to go to math channels, invert channel B. It's going to give me this extra piece. I'm going to push kind of the original waveform out. And then here now, next to each other, we can see very, very comparable. And we could do some other work. We could scale this up, right? Put it on a 2-0 scale, right? Try to get it really close. So we'll go ahead and put it there. And then let's do some work and see if I move this wand around, we'll see that it's going to influence really the amplitude of the picture that I'm getting. So depending on where I put it, even right here, I've got it right next to my other clamp, my other lead. If I go parallel with it, all these things influence the image that I see to an extent. So these COP wands are great. They're quick, they're easy. So next we're gonna take this spark plug out. We'll check the gap and then we're gonna modify the gap and see what that does to our waveform so we can get some understanding about what does that waveform tell us about spark plug condition and maybe engine condition as well. So quick trip to all data, we learned that the spec is 37 to 43 thousandths of an inch. So we're actually a little under spec and not terribly surprising. We've had this car for just a little bit now and I do this experiment as a lab in one of my classes. So there's a chance that somebody changed the gap on this and didn't put it back right. Another possibility is that somebody dropped this plug down into the well in order to install it, right? And was able to close up the gap a little bit doing so. So we're gonna go ahead and we'll start out with a larger gap. So we'll go ahead and start out with a larger gap. So I'm gonna use my gap opener tool here on the end. Stretch it just a little bit. We'll go for about twice what the spec is, which is pretty extreme. So there we're getting to about 85 thousandths, right? So that's just about right on double the highest spec. All right, engine's running. Not any noticeable difference really, no misfires, so we know that spark plug is firing. Let's go over to the software and start up our trace. And initially, we see that there are some differences. We'll pull this up and we'll get a comparison with the one that we did before. So we moved the lead to cylinder number one. We installed that with a hypertension lead. I checked the gap on that plug. It was about 32 thousandths of an inch. So we can compare the two now. So this setup of firing line here, this is on cylinder one with a more normal gap. Let's move this down. And so you'll see that the firing line is way different. We're averaging somewhere in the 4 to 5 kilovolt range. This is more normal for most vehicles at idle. All right, so we'll zoom back in. We'll take a look at some things, right? So I've got my firing line. We'll go ahead and pause one of these. You can see my dwell. I go through my fire line, my burn time, and then I've got this area here where flame goes out, it noses off, and I've got some oscillations of voltage that are left in the wire. If we look at our time scale, let's move this over just a little bit. Run it one more time. So based on my 1 millisecond per division, we are almost out to 2 milliseconds, right? We're just shy of that. Let's call it 1.8 milliseconds, right? 1.8 milliseconds from my fire line to where I nose off and my fire ends. Let's switch back to our bigger gap. All right, so then back to our larger gap plug, you can see our firing voltage is much higher. We're gonna pause one of these and look at it. Our average is a bit lower than this, right? But right here, it's hitting just over 17,000 volts. My burn time has a very similar shape and slope to my good cylinder. And we nose off, but not nearly as much, right? And so we see one of the biggest changes here is that my burn time becomes less. The rope analogy tells us that basically this distance from my burn line all the way up to my firing line is always the same length. And so if my firing voltage goes up, burn time decreases. And if my burn time increases, my firing line or firing voltage has to come down. And that's it. So that's a short experiment that I do in my classes, one of the advanced electrical classes when we talk about ignition systems and we do some scope work and really trying to dial in, you know, this waveform is foreign at first, but hopefully by doing these experiments and just making some comparisons, right, that helps to begin to build this idea about what should it look like. And at the end of the day, they're not always going to look the same, right? And so the best thing that we can do is compare. So, you know, take readings of all four cylinders, compare those. You know, if I'm chasing, say, a misfire, I could compare them all, and I'm going to learn something about, hey, which one's the odd one out. At the end of the day, it's going to take some time. I'm going to have to keep looking at this. And that's where an experiment like this really can be helpful. It gets me some experience. Gives me some practical application about what, you know, this particular car looks like and what maybe some of the variables are that influence that waveform.